Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to start the last chapter, that is probabilistic reasoning. Now here we are going to apply the probability. The probability can be either 0 or a 1. So we are going to apply the probability in different situations. Now the first point is representing knowledge in uncertain domain. Now we have seen what is by qualifying uncertainty in the last chapter or in the last session. So here we are going to how we are going to represent the knowledge in case of a uncertain domain. Now, a Bayesian network is a directed graph in which each node is annotated with quantitative probability information. The full specification is as follows. Each node corresponds to a random variable which may be discrete or continuous. Second point, a set of directed links or arrows connects pairs of nodes. If there is an arrow from node X to node Y, X is said to be a parent of Y. The graph has no directed cycles and hence is a directed acyclic graph or DAG, that is directed acyclic graph. Each node Xi has a conditional probability distribution, probability of Xi or parents of Xi that quantifies the effect of the parents on the node. The topology of the network, the set of nodes and links specifies the conditional independence relationship that holds in the domain in a way that will be made precise shortly. The intuitive remaining of an arrow is typically that X has a direct influence on Y, which suggests that causes should be parents of effect. It is usually easy for a domain expert to decide what direct influence exists in the domain. Much easier in the fact that actually specifying the probabilities themselves. Once the topology of the Bayesian network is laid down, we need only specify a condition, the probability distribution for each variable given its parent. We will see the combination of the topology and the conditional distribution suffices to specify the full joint distribution for all the variables. Now here is the example of a simple Bayesian network in which weather is independent of the other three variables. So we have taken example as a cavity. Cavity can be K or catch, but it is independent of the weather. Weather has no meaning with the cavity. Now the next example is a typical Bayesian network. Now there is an alarm in the Bulgaria because there is earthquake. John calls and Mary calls. So this is a typical example showing the topology of conditional probability tables. So there can be a condition when the earthquake occurs, there is alarm. Now alarm is going to send to the John calls and Mary calls. Now the information over here is the earthquake information is presented by the table and the earthquake happens in the Bulgaria. And this information is shared with the John calls and Mary calls. The conditional probability distribution is shown in this figure are shown as a conditional probability table, that is CPT. Each row in the CPT contains the conditional probability of each node value for conditioning case. The next point is semantics of Bayesian network. First point is representing the full joint distribution. Viewed as a piece of the syntax, a Bayesian network is a directed acyclic graph with some numeric parameters attached to each node. One way to define what the network means, its semantics is to define the way in which it represents a specific joint distribution over all the variables. To do this, we first need to retract, that is temporarily, what we said earlier about the parameters associated with each node. We said that those parameters correspond to conditional probabilities. So the probability of Xi or parents of Xi. This is true statement, but until we assign semantics to the network as a whole, we should think of them just as numbers. So theta of Xi or parent of Xi. Now we can formulate this with A generic entry in the joint distribution is the probability of conjunction of a particular assignment to each variable, such as probability of x1 is equal to x1 disjunction up to disjunction xn is equal to xn. Now we use notation p of x1 up to xn is an abbreviation for this. This is the mathematical formula to solve it. The next point is compactness and node ordering. As well as being a complete non-redundant representation of the domain, a Bayesian network can often be far more compact than the full joint distribution. This property is what makes it feasible to handle domain with many variables. The compactness of Bayesian network is an example of a general property of locally structured system. In locally structured system, each subcomponent interacts directly with only a bounded number of other components, regardless of the total number of components. Local structure is usually associated with linear rather than exponential growth in complexity. In case of Bayesian network, it is reasonable to support that in most domains, each domain variable is directly influenced by at most k others for some constant k. If we assume n Boolean variables for simplicity, then the amount of information needed to specify each conditional probability table will be at most 2 raised to k numbers, and the complete network can be specified by n into 2 raised to k numbers. In contrast, joint distribution contains 2 raised to n numbers. To make this concrete, suppose we have n nodes, each with 5 parents, k is equal to 5, then Bayesian network requires 960 numbers, but the full joint distribution requires over the billion. Now here is the network structure representation depends on order of introduction. In each network, we have introduced nodes in a top to bottom order. Now here is the explanation for the entire diagram. Even in a locally structured domain, we will get a compact Bayesian network only if we choose the node ordering well. What happens if we happen to choose the wrong order? Consider a Bulgari example again. Suppose we decide to add the nodes in the order Mary calls, John calls, alarm, Bulgari, earthquake. We then get somewhat more complicated network shown in the figure 14.3. The process goes as follows. Adding Mary calls, no parents. Adding John calls, if Mary calls, that probably means the alarm has gone off, which of course would make it more likely than John calls. Therefore, John calls needs Mary calls as a parent. Adding alarm, clearly if both calls, it is more likely that the alarm has gone off than if just one or neither calls. So we need both Mary calls and John calls as parents. Now here is the explanation of what the figure is going to tell to us. Next point is conditional independence relation in Bayesian network. We have provided a numerical semantic for Bayesian network in terms of representation of the full joint distribution. Using this semantic to derive the method for constructing Bayesian network, we were led to the consequence that a node is conditionally independent of its other precedents, given its parent. It turns out that we can also go in other direction. We can start from a topology semantics that specifies the conditional independence relationship encoded by the graph structure, and from this we can derive the numerical semantic. The topological semantics specified that each variable is conditionally independent of its non-descendants, given its parents. For example, in the last figure, John calls is independent of Bulgari, earthquake, and Mary calls given a value of alarm. The definitions illustrated in the figure 14.4a. From these conditional independence assertions and interpretation of the network parameters, so theta of xi are parents of xi as specifications of conditional probabilities. So the probability of xi are parents of xi, the full joint distribution given in equation 14.2 can be reconstructed. In this sense, the numerical semantics and the topological semantics are equivalent. The next point is efficient representation of conditional distributions. Even if the number, a maximum number of parent k is smallish, filling in the CPT of for a node requires up to order of 2^k numbers and perhaps a great deal of experience with all the possible conditioning cases. In fact, there is a worst case scenario in which the relationship between the parents and the child is completely arbitrary. Usually such relationships are describable by canonical distribution that fits some standard pattern. In such cases, the complete table can be specified by naming the pattern and perhaps supplying few parameters, much easier than supplying an exponential number of parameters. The simplest example is provided by deterministic nodes. A deterministic node has its value specified exactly by the value of its parent with no uncertainty. The relationship can be a logical one. For example, the relationship between the parent node, Canadian, US, Mexican, and the child node, North American, is simply that the child is a disjunction of the parent. The relationship can also be numerical. For example, if the parent node R, the prices of a particular model of a car at several dealers, and the child node is the price that a Bulgarian hunter ends up paying, then the child node is minimum of the parent value, or the parent nodes are a lex inflow and outflow, and the child is the change of the water level of the lake, then the value of the child is the sum of the inflow parents minus the sum of the outflow parents. Uncertain relationship can often be characterized by so-called noisy logical relationship. So noisy means this is logical relationship, that is uncertain relationship. The standard example is the noisy OR relation, which is a generalization of the logical OR. In proportional logic, we might say that fever is true if and only if cold, flu, or malaria is true. Now this is the truth table for cold, flu, and malaria. So when the malaria will be true or when the malaria will be false, if cold and flu is false, malaria is false. If the cold and flu is true, malaria is true. So like this, you can recognize the truth table. In general, the noisy logical relationship in which the variable depends on k parents can be described with using order of k parameters instead of order of 2^k for the full conditional probability table. This makes assessment and learning much easier. So next we are talking about the Bayesian nets with continuous variables. Many real world problems involve continuous quantities such as height, mass, temperature, money. In fact, much of the statistics deals with the random variables whose domains are continuous. By definition, continuous variables have an infinite number of possible values. This is a simple network with the discrete variables. Subsidy is a variable, harvest, cost, and buys. So we have taken an example. The temperatures could be divided into less than 0 degrees centigrade, 0 to 100 degrees centigrade, and greater than 100 degrees centigrade. Discretization is sometimes an adequate solution, but often results in a considerable loss of accuracy and very large CPTs. The most common solution is to define standard families of probability density functions that are specified by a finite number of parameters. For example, a Gaussian or a normal distribution, that is N, nu, sigma raised to sigma square x has the mean nu and variables sigma square as parameters. The next point is exact inference in Bayesian network. The basic task for any probabilistic inference system is to compute the posterior probability distribution for a set of query variables given some observed event, that is some assignment of a value to a set of evidence variables. To simplify the presentation, we will consider only one query variable at a time. The algorithm can be easily be extended to queries with multiple variables. We will use the notation from the chapter 13 from the previous chapter. X denotes the query variable, E denotes the set of evidences variable E1 up to EM, and small e is a particular observed event. Y will be denotes the non-evidence non-query variables Y1 up to YL, called as hidden variables. Thus, a complete set of variables is X. Now, this will be the set representation. A typical query asks for the posterior probability distribution, probability of X or E. Now, in Bulgarian network, we might observe that the event in which John calls is true, Mary calls is true. So, we can represent the probability like this. Next is inference by enumeration. Now, more specifically, a query probability of X or E can be answered using the equation this. Now, a Bayesian network gives a complete representation of the full joint distribution. More specifically, equation 14.2 on the pages. Okay, so from this 14.2 point shows that the terms probability of X, E, Y in the joint distribution can be written as a product of conditional probability from the network. Therefore, a query can be answered using a Bayesian network by computing some of the products of conditional probabilities from the network. Consider the query, probability of Bulgari or John's is equal to true and Mary is equal to true. The hidden variable for this query are earthquake and alarm from the equation 13.9 using initial letters for the variables to shorten the expression. So we have this equation. The next point is the variable elimination algorithm. The enumeration algorithm can be improved substantially by eliminating repeated calculations of the kind illustrated in this figure. The idea is simple: do the calculation once and save the result for the later use. This is the function that is enumeration ask. This is the function name. The inputs are X, E, B, N, and it is going to return a distribution over the X. Inputs are X, the query variable, E, observed variable for variable E, observed value for variable E, BN, that is bias net with variable X union E union Y. Now, Y is a hidden variables. Q of X is a distribution over X. Initially, it is empty. This is the logic for empty enumeration ask. And second function, that is enumerate tell. Variable and E, these are the inputs, and return a real number. If empty variable, then it is going to return 1.0. So this is the logic for the function enumerate tell, and output will be a real number, and this function ask function output is a return over distribution over X. This is the return value. The next point is approximate inference in Bayesian network. The first point of this is direct sampling methods. The primitive elements in any sampling algorithm is the generation of samples from a known probability distribution. For example, an unbiased coin can be thought of as a random variable coin with value head and tails, and prior distribution P coin is 0.5 and 0.5. Sampling from this distribution is exactly like flipping the coin. With probability of 0.5, it will return heads, and with probability 0.5, it will return tails. Given a source of random number uniformly distributed in the range 0 to 1, it is a simple matter to sample any distribution on a single variable whether discrete or continuous. The simplest kind of random sampling process for Bayesian network generates events from the network that has no events associated with it. The idea is simple. The idea is to sample each variable in turn in topological order. So, sample from P1, P is cloudy. Sample from this P means probability. So we can write out the equation like this for direct sampling methods. Now, how we are going to make the logic? So we are writing the function prior sample, that is BN, returns an event sampled from the prior specified BN. These are the inputs, and the output will be an event simplified sampled from a prior specified by BN. The next point is relational and first order probability models. Now, in this chapter 8, we have explained the representation advantages possessed by first order logic in the comparison to proportional logic. The first order logic commits to the existence of object and relations among them and can express fact about some or all of the objects in a domain. This often results in representations that are vastly more concise and equivalent to proportional descriptions. Now, the Bayesian network are essentially propositional. The set of random variables is fixed and finite, and each has a fixed domain of possible values. This fact limits the applicability of Bayesian network. If we can find a way to combine probability theory with expansive power of first-order representations, we expect to be able to increase diagrammatic the range of problems that can be handled. For example, suppose that an online book retailer would like to provide overall evaluations of product based on the recommendations received from its customer. The evaluation will take the form of posterior distribution over the quality of books given the available evidence. The simplest solution is to base the evaluation on average recommendation, perhaps with a variance determined by a number of recommendations. But this fails to take into account the fact that some customers are kinder than the others and some are less honest than the others. Now, the first point from this is possible words. For Bayesian network, the possible words are assignment of values to variables. For Boolean case in particular, the possible words are identical to those of the proportional logic. For a first order probability model, then it seems we need the possible words to be those of the first order logic, that is, the set of objects with relations among them and interpretation that maps constant symbols to object predicate symbols to relations and function symbols to functions on those objects. This model also needs to define the probability for each such words just as a Bayesian network. So this is the representation of equation for the possible words. So an unusual, we can obtain the probability of any first order logic sentence phi as a sum over the possible words. So probability of phi is equal to summation of omega phi is true in omega. Next point is relational probability models. Like the first order logic, RPMs have a constants, functions and predicate symbols. We will also assume a type signature for each function, that is, the specification of the type of each argument and function's value. If the type of each object is known, many spurious possible words are eliminated by this mechanism. For the book recommendation domain, the types of customers and book types are customers and book. So the honest will be the customer, quality will be book, and recommendation will be customer into books. Now the last point is other approaches to uncertain reasoning. So we are talking about the uncertain reasoning where we have talked about the first order logic also. We have taken example of probability also. Now from this, the first point is rule based methods for uncertain reasoning. First, that's locality. In logical systems, whenever we have a rule of the form A implies B, we can conclude B given evidence A without worrying about the other rules. In probabilistic system, we need to consider all the evidence. detachment once a logical proof is found for proposition B. Proposition can be used regardless of how it was derived. That is, it can be detached from its jurisdiction in dealing with probabilities. On the other hand, the source of evidence for the belief is important for subsequent reasoning. Next is third, truth functionality. In logic, the truth of complex sentence can be computed from the truth of component. Probabilistic combination does not work this way, except under the strong global independence assumptions. Next point is representing ignorance, Damsper-Safra theory. So here we return to the coin flipping example of the previous. Suppose you pick up a coin from a magician's pocket. Given that the coin might or may not be fair, what belief should be ascribed to event that comes to be heads? So here we have taken the example of this. We have no evidence either way. You have to say that the belief bell heads is zero, and also bell negation of heads is zero. To make the Damsper-Safra reasoning system skeptical in a way that some intuitive appears. Now suppose you have an expert at your disposal who testify with 90% certainty that the coin is fair, that is 90% sure the probability of heads is 0.5. Next point is representing vagueness, fuzzy sets and fuzzy logic. Fuzzy sets theory is a means of specifying how well an object satisfies a vague description, that is unclear description. Now the fuzzy logic is a method for reasoning with logical expressions describing membership in a fuzzy set. For example, the complex sentence tall net, negation heavy net has a fuzzy truth value, that is that a function of truth value of its component. The standard rule for evaluating the fuzzy truth T of the complex sentence R. So this is example of tautology where we are going to apply the fuzzy logic. So this was the end of this chapter, probabilistic reasoning, and this was the last chapter of the syllabus. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.